Sorry guys, I had to shut down my video in between because of some personal problem. So let me continue from the part here. So photolysis or photooxidation of water will release electrons which are accepted by the unknown electron acceptor, which is Z, and will send the electrons to the reaction center or the core complex of PS2, which is P680. Also, energy coming from the sunlight will be absorbed by the antenna molecules, sending this absorbed energy to the reaction center of PS2. As you can see these arrows represent the flow of energy from the antenna molecule to the reaction center. This will excite the reaction center of PS2. So now, as the reaction center of PS2 is reduced or it is having high electron potential, will definitely show a high tendency to donate or lose its electron to some other electron intermediate or electron acceptor having comparatively lower electron potential. So the first electron or intermediate electron acceptor of PS2 is pheophytin. I have written the abbreviation here. I will describe the full forms later on. So pheophytin, I have written pheo here, is the first intermediate electron acceptor of PS2, which is having a low electron potential as compared to the reaction center of PS2. So electrons from PS2 will move to pheophytin or will be sent to pheophytin, which is the first electron acceptor of PS2. And you can see here there are two electrons released during the process of photooxidation of water, will travel the whole cycle without changing its amount. So all along the cycle, or so from the starting up to the end, till the end, two electrons will be flown. So two electrons will enter into the reaction center of PS2, will move into the first intermediate electron acceptor of PS2, which is pheophytin. So pheophytin is now reduced and reaction center of PS2, which is P680, is now oxidized because electrons are released from PS2 or reaction center of PS2 to the pheophytin. Now pheophytin is having high electron potential and it is reduced, so it needs its electrons to get released. So it will release its electron to some other intermediate having low electron potential as compared to pheophytin. So the next electron acceptor is QA. QA is basically cyclic acceptor. So QA is having a low electron potential as compared to pheophytin. So electrons will move or will be released by pheophytin to QA. And now pheophytin is oxidized and QA is reduced. In this same mechanism or same process, QA having high electron potential and it is reduced will have a high tendency to lose or donate its electron to some other intermediate having low electron potential. So it will release its electron to PQ, which is plastoquinone. So from QA, which is reduced and having high electron potential, will release its electron to the next electron acceptor, which is PQ or plastoquinone. If you notice here, PQ undergoes reduction by the acceptance of electron, also due to the presence or acceptance of hydrogen ion coming from the medium. This is the medium, and medium is basically outer thylakoid membrane. So hydrogen ion will move to PQ, which will make PQH2. So PQH2 is plastohydroquinone, and this is a reversible process. You can see the two arrows representing both the directions, that is forward as well as backward direction. So PQ will accept a hydrogen ion obtained from the medium of outer thylakoid membrane to form PQH2, which is plastohydroquinone. Now, from plastohydroquinone, electrons will move into cytochrome F. And during the process of this transfer of electron, one ATP molecule is synthesized by ADP, that is adenosine diphosphate and inorganic phosphate. So using inorganic phosphate and adenosine diphosphate, that is ADP, one ATP is produced, which is the first assimilatory power. So you need to remember this this portion of the non-cyclic photophosphorylation, during which one ATP molecule is synthesized, and this ATP molecule will immediately be transported to the outer thylakoid membrane. You can see transport is written here. So from this particular region, ATP will be sent or transferred to the outer thylakoid membrane. So ATP will reach the outer thylakoid membrane. Similarly, from cytochrome F, electrons will flow to PC, which is plastocyanin. From plastocyanin, the electrons will move into PS1, or the reaction center of PS1, which is P720. So from PC, electrons will move into PS1, or the reaction center of PS1, which is P720. So from PS1, and along with the absorption of light energy, electrons will be sent to the first electron acceptor of PS1, which is A1. A1 from A3 is representing the first, second and third electron acceptors of PS1, which are unknown. That is A1 up to A3. These electron acceptors are basically unknown, not very much known to us. So these are unknown electron acceptors, or the first electron acceptors of PS1, and these are A1, A2, A3. Electrons will flow from A1 to A2 to A3 till FD, that is ferrodoxin. FD is ferrodoxin. So electron from A3 will move into ferrodoxin or FD. This electron will help in the process of synthesis or formation of NADPH2+, which is the second assimilatory power. So ferrodoxin will release its electron to the outer thylakoid membrane in the presence of FRN and two hydrogen ions. FRN is basically ferrodoxin NADP reductase enzyme. FRN is ferrodoxin NADP reductase enzyme, along with two hydrogen ions and electrons in the outer thylakoid membrane. NADPH2+ is synthesized from NADP+. So NADP+ is undergoing the process of reduction to synthesize NADPH2+, which is the second assimilatory power. So question may be asked, like after which process NADPH2+ is synthesized, or after which reaction NADPH2+ is synthesized. So electrons accepted from PC to the PS1 reaction center will move to the unknown electron acceptors, or the first electron acceptors of PS1, which are A1, A2, A3, will move into FD or ferrodoxin, ultimately to the outer thylakoid membrane, where in the presence of FRN, which is ferrodoxin NADP reductase enzyme, along with two hydrogen ions, from NADP+, NADPH2+ is synthesized, which is the second assimilatory power. So towards the outer thylakoid membrane, concentration of hydrogen ions or protons is very less. The square bracket here is representing the concentration of hydrogen ion, which is very less in the outer thylakoid membrane. But in the inner thylakoid membrane, as you can see, there are many hydrogen ions. So the concentration of hydrogen ions in inner thylakoid membrane is very large, because hydrogen ions are accepted or taken from this outer thylakoid membrane medium. As you can see here, hydrogen ion is taken by PQ from the outer thylakoid membrane. So definitely the concentration of hydrogen ions will decrease as compared to the inner thylakoid membrane, where during the process of photolysis of water, hydrogen ions are produced, which are liberated into the inner thylakoid membrane, and therefore increasing the concentration of hydrogen ions in the inner thylakoid membrane as compared to outer thylakoid membrane. So I think this is clear to you all, but in a nutshell, if I describe this process or describe the non-cyclic photophosphorylation, it is basically in PS1 complex, electrons flow from A3 complex, which is received by ferredoxin or FD. FD now gives the electrons to NADP plus to reduce it into NADPH2 plus. If you notice this portion first, I am defining PS1 first. So in PS1 complex, electrons will travel from A3 complex to FD, which is ferredoxin, and electrons from ferredoxin will be received by NADP plus and undergoing the process of reduction to form NADPH2 plus along with two hydrogen ions taken up from the medium, that is here, with the help of an enzyme known as ferredoxin NADP reductase complex or NADP reductase enzyme. If you notice this portion that is represented by PS2, then the statement will be written as, in PS2 complex, after photo excitation of PS2 or the reaction center of PS2. This is basically photo excitation of PS2 or the reaction center of PS2. Why photo excitation? Because photons are absorbed by the antenna molecules. Photons are basically energy coming from the sunlight absorbed by the antenna molecules of PS2. So this is the photo excitation of PS2 or the reaction center of PS2. The first intermediate electron acceptor is pheophytin, creating a hole. So the first electron acceptor, which is pheophytin, will create a hole here, because a void is created because electrons will flow from reaction center of PS2 to pheophytin. So due to the flow of electron, there will be a space created in the reaction center of PS2. Electrons from photo oxidation of water is trapped by the reaction center of PS2, which is P680, as I have already defined. So from pheophytin, QA or cununoid acceptor will accept electron. In this way, PQ will accept electron along with the uptake of hydrogen ion to form PQH2, which is plastohydroquinone. So from QA, which is cununoid acceptor, electrons will flow to PQ, which is plastoquinone, involved in the formation of PQH2 with the uptake of hydrogen ion from the outer thylakoid membrane or the medium of outer thylakoid membrane. This is a reversible reaction, as the arrow representing both forward as well as backward reaction. Now electrons from PQH2 will move to cytochrome F here of cytochrome B6F complex. So cytochrome F is basically the part of cytochrome B6F complex. During this process, ATP is synthesized, and this reaction or this part is basically known as photophosphorylation. Photophosphorylation. So non-cyclic photophosphorylation. Photophosphorylation because ATP is synthesized during this process, that is transfer of electrons from PQH2 or plastohydroquinone to cytochrome F. During this process, ATP is synthesized, and hence this particular portion of reaction is known as photophosphorylation, and therefore the name is non-cyclic photophosphorylation. So the reduced cytochrome F, because it is now having the electron accepted by PQH2, or the reduced cytochrome F gives electron to PC, and PC gives electron to photosystem 1 to fill its hole. So from cytochrome F, electrons will move to PC, and ultimately from PC, PS1 is accepting the electron. And why I have said that the hole is filled in PS1 by the acceptance of electrons? Because this was initially oxidized. Okay, this was initially oxidized, so it will accept electrons to get reduced. So oxidized form is basically defined as having a hole or space into which electrons will be trapped, and ultimately the reaction center of PS1 will be reduced. So the hole is filled, or the void is filled in PS1 due to the acceptance of electrons from PC or plastocyanin. So I think this is now clear. The non-cyclic photophosphorylation reaction, and why it is non-cyclic photophosphorylation reaction, because the electrons here are not sent back to PS2 or not sent back to PS1. It is used up to form NADPH2+. So it is non-cyclic because electrons are not sent back or not transferred to the reaction centers of PS2 as well as PS1. So the reaction is followed in this mechanism, that is Z scheme or non-cyclic process, because electrons are not flowing back to reaction center PS2, reaction center of PS2 and reaction center of PS1. Instead, it is used up to form the second assimilatory power, which is NADPH2+. So in my next video, the topic is cyclic photophosphorylation. But before I conclude, I would like to give you the full forms which are written here. Pheophytin, or pheophytin, which is written as pheo, which is the abbreviation of pheophytin, is the first electron or intermediate electron acceptor of PS2. The second abbreviation which I have written during the reaction process was QA, quinonoid acceptor, PQ, plastoquinone, PQH2, plastohydroquinone, A1 to A3. These are the first, second and third electron acceptors of PS1, unknown, because their presence or their name or their existence is not very known to the scientist, so these are unknown. And FRN is the ferredoxine NADP reductase enzyme or NADP reductase complex, and FD is ferredoxine. So you might become confused. Please jot down the points and note down this whole reaction mechanism or the diagram which I have drawn on the board to make the concept clear. I know this is a little bit confusing, but I have tried my level best to explain this whole process as easily as I can. So please watch my next video to know about cyclic photophosphorylation. Thank you.